Mabungurangura. Welcome to the Gimme Sessions at the Gimme Club. Ngāu nilawal nāru pigram, wadiri and yaru jandu here on Jugun and Yaru Buru. I'd like to pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging and to acknowledge that these lands were never ceded. Tonight we're simulcast on GTV, Radio Galari, galari.com, and we're here to celebrate the amazing musical talents of our Kimberley artists. Tonight in the studio, I would like to welcome the sweet, soulful singer-songwriter, Adele Oliver.
Thanks welcome. For having me.
No worries. How are you going tonight?
Good, yeah. I'm really excited to get up and play.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay, so today I listened to Don't Take My Blues Away.
Yeah.
And it's a very beautiful song.
Thank you.
I love how you used, I want to say depression.
Yeah.
But that's not kind of the word I'm looking for. Look, you talk about all the beautiful things in the world and tell them to go away.
Yeah.
And just tell us where the inspiration came for that, because I kind of think I might know what you're talking about there.
So basically, I guess it's drawing on feelings of depression. I've never like suffered in long enough bouts to be diagnosed clinically or anything, but I definitely have periods of time where I'll sink into feelings of. And so that song, I was imagining like when I looked out the window that it should have been a rainy, gloomy day. That was how I was feeling inside, but instead it was beautiful, sunny. And all of the things I was looking around at weren't usually, that would cheer me up and make me feel good, weren't working. And so I just kind of sat with it, as I've learned to do. It's best to kind of not rush feelings past, but sit and let yourself feel it. And that's what I was doing that day. And I thought I'd write a song about it. Instead of just feeling blue, I came out with something good, I hope.
It's beautiful. Oh, it's amazing. And that's your debut EP?
Yeah, debut single. Yeah.
And how did you come to record it? I believe you were mentored by one of our other guests that we've had on the show, Tanya Ransom, the Women in Song at AMCOS.
Women in Music. So after AMCOS, they released a program last year where you could be mentored through your first release by someone. Tanya was our mentor, and it was really good because there was only one position in Broome, but she really wanted both me and Mon, and so they split it and had both of us mentored through Tanya. And so she would sit down with us, catch up almost kind of monthly or sometimes weekly, or by the phone. She was really, really, really like available for us, and we would call her, talk to her about the process and like the steps in line that we had to go through. And then I had it recorded by Pete Granderson, and then and then released at Good Cartel. So it was really nice. When I stood up to go play, I kind of got really overwhelmed with feelings just of quite gratitude, because it was a really beautiful day.
Yeah.
And I've got the song out there now, so I was happy.
Oh, it's a beautiful song. I absolutely love it. And I'm kicking myself that I haven't heard more of your music sooner, but now I'm a fan, so.
Thank you.
Looking forward to what's coming next. But I wanted to ask you a little bit about growing up in Broome.
Yeah.
You have a tendency in your lyrics to really take in your surroundings, and that's a beautiful thing. So what was your favourite, what's one of your favourite memories growing up in Broome?
I guess it's camping memories tend to feature quite heavily for me. I'd written another song about this trip that we took with Mum and Dad from Broome all the way up to Darwin, and we drove through some like national parks on the way, and it was about 2 weeks of just non-stop camping, family time.
Wow.
And they're like the memories that I really pull on when I'm writing songs mostly. And I think also like, you know, interactions with people. Definitely Broome music's inspired me, you know, growing up with the sounds of the Pigram Brothers. I think it's that, all of those.
Instruments, I did ask you
this. Yeah.
But so you don't play piano. Your song Don't Take My Blues Away has beautiful piano on it, and you said you wished you
I
could
know.
Play.
I wished
Is
I could play
something
piano.
You've ever
I've tried. So I just learnt guitar by sort of self-learning chords on the internet in high school, but I didn't have the kind of the music lessons and theory that I kind of wish I had at a younger age. I could still learn now, but I kind of, yeah. So I can sometimes jump on piano and I might like play some chords really clunkily, but
just, to help you write the,
well, just to have it, yeah, just to have a bit of fun on it. I don't have a piano at home, but just that, I think, yeah, that song I always imagined just this free flowing piano, and I looked at him playing it and just wished that that was me, but glad he was on the song.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
And your guitar playing is pretty spiffy as well. How old were you when you picked it up?
I was handed the guitar at St. Mary's by the dance teacher, and she just gave me a nylon string guitar, and she was like, look, and here's the chords, and you look them up at these kind of websites. And so I think she must have seen that I was pretty keen to play, so I started playing like Missy Higgins covers and stuff like that, artists like that, and the Waifs. But yeah,
are they inspirations for you today?
Yeah, I think there's like lots of artists that have probably inspired me over the period of like time that I've been writing songs. I think at the moment the artists I would like to write songs like would be John Prine.
Oh no.
Yeah, so
rest in peace
to him. But yeah, I think all of the, and there's so many artists in Australia that I've definitely been inspired by those two for sure.
Yeah nice. I feel like you've also got your own sound out of those influences as well, so that's really, really nice.
Yeah.
What feeds your soul other than music?
Camping. Music's a big one, that would be the major one. Camping. Food?
Yeah, that's something.
That would be.
Why not? It's sustenance.
Yeah, but I think just landscapes, camping, and conversation too. Yeah, learning other people's stories.
Beautiful. And where can we find your music?
Just the one song on Spotify for now, and iTunes as well. Hopefully there'll be more available soon.
And you got a Facebook page?
Yeah, Facebook and Instagram, same usual.
Adele Oliver.
Yeah, Adele Oliver Music for Facebook, and yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, wonderful. Yep. Well, I wanted to thank you for coming in, and you're going to play some tunes for us today, and I'm so excited. I finally get to see you live, and I really hope that your journey that you shared with us today just goes to the highest of heights, and I believe it will. So.
Thank you for having me.
No worries.
Good afternoon. My name's Adele Oliver. Thank you for having me at the beautiful Gimme Sessions. And Anari's done a welcome just before, but I would like to acknowledge the Yaru people as the traditional owners of the land that I'm on right now, and to pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. This song that I'm going to play first is called Don't Take My Blues Away. It's the only song that I've released officially, so it's out there on Spotify, iTunes, and it's about the feeling of blue and sadness that you just can't shake despite looking out at all of the beauty in the world around you. So Don't Take My Blues Away.
It's shining through my window. Take the blue from the sky, 'cause it looks too nice outside. Take the breeze from the trees, though it is too pleasant. Ooh. take the colors from the sunset. Oh, they are too good for my eyes. And take the birds right out of the sky, 'cause they are making me want to fly. Take all the good things from within my reach. Oh, I'm not worthy today. And won't you take all the things that I normally praise, but don't take my blues away. To take all the things that I normally praise, but don't take my blues away.
So to counteract the seriousness of that song, I'm going to just play a little bit happier tune. This next song is about packing up on the Friday evening and going camping under a full moon, stars. I was really lucky to live for the past 3 years in Fitzroy Crossing, and there's lots of beautiful riverbed camping that you can do. So this is inspired by that. This one's called Silver Night.
Dry riverbed. We'll count these stars as we rest our heads. 'Cause we've been traveling a while, dirt and dust in our eyes. Starry sky, and in the glow of the moonlight, won't you lay me down under the silver night and hold me close by the fireside, and sweet dreams will carry me. And there's no one else around my day, so for miles and miles, and you can feel the emptiness and let it soothe your mind. Oh, under the starry sky, in the glow of the moonlight, won't you lay me down under the silver night and hold me close by the fireside, and sweet dreams will carry me as a full moon rises in the northern sky. I'll sing you a sweet lullaby. Dreams carry me. Losing all sense of time, the world has stopped. you and I, sharing in this moment with the stars, fall away into our paradise. So won't you lay me down under the silver night, hold me close by the
next song is called Dear Luca, and it was written for my friend who was carrying a beautiful little bub in her tummy growing, and I just find that to be one of the most special things in the world, and so I wrote this song for them. Dear Luke's. You have So I pretty much will write songs about everything around me. And this next one's about being catcalled. Pretty common phenomena for females, but this one time I just sort of thought to myself, you know what? What about my brain? You're not judging that, are you? I wrote this song because this group of guys whistled out Legs 11, and I don't know, I was probably having a day, but anyway, this is what the song that came back out of it. I think it's that feeling of just being totally judged by only your physical appearance and not everything else. So this is called Legs 11. That one, but needed to be said. Didn't think of it at the time, but yeah. So this next one is written about going camping. We took a trip with Mum, Dad, and my sister, and we spent 2 weeks driving from Broome up to Darwin, and it was such a beautiful time. And I've got some really strong memories from that camping trip. I wrote it when I was living in Perth and it was winter, and I was dreaming of better days. It's called Lovely Days.
Dream of open skies, far from city lights, where you can see for miles. And the Milky Way is as clear as day, not competing for the night. Dirt beneath your feet and bulldust in your sheets, drinking water from the creek. Oh, the simple days where you can lay with a book beneath the tree. Well, it's far away, so I go there in my dreams. The lovely days, drinking from the stream. Oh, and it's far away, so I go there in my dreams. To the lovely days. Won't pass say so on the dusty road, but at least we've got each other. And we'll scrap and fight to our hearts delight, and then we share the tent at night. Oh, it's far away, so I go there in my dreams to the lovely days of drinking from the stream. It's far away, so I go there in my dreams to the lovely days. And now I'm grown, I'll never let it go. The memory stays in my mind, and I hold it close. The smell still touch my nose of the cleanest air I know. I still hear the sound of nature all around. I hope it follows me too. Go there in my dreams to the lovely days of drinking from the stream. Oh, when it's far away, so I go there in my dreams to the lovely days. Dreaming
of camping. I used to say that the song I played before, Dear Luca, was the only love song in my set, but I've added a new one recently. It's a falling out of love song. And this one's called I Wish All the Best for You.
Yesterday the loneliness was weighing me down. I've been sitting here too long, staring at the blank pages of you and I, trying to write us into a song. And I've never been one for soppy love songs, but I feel that I owe you this. So listen up, baby, 'cause I'm gonna make it 3.5 minutes long. Oh, 3.5 minutes of a love song. Plenty of time to tell you that I loved you dearly, and our love was true, and I wish all the best. far gone. And I was looking at the pieces, us on the floor, there were two men missing a behold. And I've never needed to write a love song, never left any words unsaid. So listen up, baby, 'cause I've gone and made you 3.5 minute song.
The next song in the set is about a young girl who was in the media like a couple years ago now. I thought my guitar was off. She was in the media a little while ago for not standing for the anthem, and she was just so dragged through the mud by some of the leaders of the country. That I wrote this open letter to them. It's called More Like Her.
You should all be more like her. 9 years old and more in form. His job it is to uphold the values of justice for inequality. She was taught to use her mind, but only at the right time. Then back in 1878, the song that represents one face, sing it back to Australia to wear, to a nation of fairness and just skin and air. And she refused to bow her head and to an obsolete anthem. And it said she was too young to have opinions of her own. them said go somewhere else. Hanson chimed in, couldn't help herself. But how empty do their lives have to be to attack a bright young mind had an adolescence for free? Oh, you talk about free speech, but she didn't say a thing.
We've got a running joke in the family about all the dogs that are pretty much like the grandchildren because no one's had bubs yet. And so instead of, you know, commenting on parenting for children, it's the dog's behaviour that gets all the focus. So this song is a bit of a joke in the family about my sister's little girl, Hula.
A good girl, her mother says it's so, and Roy's been sitting there watching her every move. Max sits in his chair all day watching life passing by. He's going blind, long lost his mind, so he doesn't have a clue. Lately mom has been dropping hints about your girl. Say she's fine, she say she's out of line and needs professional help. Could it be something surfacing from a previous life? Could it be the lack of boundaries that she's had in this life? Ooh, the baby, they try to make you look crazy. Troubled girl, a baby blue eyes will only get you so far in this modern world. And it's no secret raising children is hard, but it's much harder than moving home with your dog at 29. Ooh, the baby, they try and make you look crazy.
It's a bad rap, that young girl. This next song is called Bleeding River, and I wrote it inspired by one of the smaller rivers that run into the Fitzroy River that was completely dried out by station just needing to, I don't know, get across. And it kind of feeds back into the bigger issue of our rivers and the fact that they're under threat, the Fitzroy River in particular, from irrigation, big business. And I guess this song's kind of like just the concern of, are we learning the lessons from our past and protecting our rivers in this country, the Bleeding River.
I've been bled dry, I've been left for dead, 'cause you're greedy and it took all that I had. You won't regret what you've done to me, or the scars you've
to then sort of finish it with on a happy note. The next song is Everything Will Be Okay. I wrote it on a week where I was having probably a tough week, and me and some girls from work, friends of mine, were kind of counselling each other through things, and by the end of the week I sort of had written this song, sat back and listened to it, and I was like, I think that might have been what I needed to hear. So this one's called Everything Will Be Okay.
Days in life, the world seems to be really pushing at your sanity, trying to get inside and mess with your head. Like when your dogs run away after your job's gonna follow and your partner's too, so you're looking around for something that might help. Oh, when life's throwing you down and you don't feel like taking another round, we'll go swimming in the mighty Fitzroy River, let the water wash away all our demons. We'll take a walk along the never-ending plain. I'll be with you every little step and turn, no matter how long it takes you to learn that everything will be okay. Well, it might be all that I can do is just sit back and talk shit with you. We can yarn about the weather or the what's been playing on the television, what a mess that's coming, and the rest created, and where's our future headed in this complex taking another round. We'll go swimming in the mighty Fitzroy River, let the water wash away old Aldine's ore. Take a walk along the never-ending flats. I'll be with you every little step and turn.
Thanks to Galari for having me here and everyone on board. Thanks, guys.
Gullamubble. Thank you, Adele. We'd like to thank our sponsors, our gorgeous cast and deadliest crew. Tune in next time for another amazing Gimme session here at the Gimme Club. Galari.